Are you able to hear me?
Yes.
Little louder.
Sorry?
Little louder.
Little louder. Thank you. Okay, dignitaries on the dais, my esteemed audience there. I somehow don't like standing behind a dais and talking, and I hope you don't mind me actually standing in front of you and doing the talking here. When I was thinking about this session here and how I was probably going to start all of this, it was my message was something very radical, very different from what probably you're going to hear across the 2 days and probably what you heard as we started off here. Because I was going to say that we have to move away from what we call here as M2M. We've been talking about M2M for a long, long time. We probably need to take a step forward and start thinking beyond M2M. I mean, we've been talking this language for a long time now. And when I was thinking essentially as to how I probably do that, thankfully, Mr. Vimal and Mr. Bahul Guna gave me those initial tidbits so that I can use them and use that as a context into going towards the message that I wanted to essentially deliver. I probably need to thank you for that. So, one key thing which Mr. Vimal said was around, he worked on cybernetics almost over 30 years back. He said you started working on cybernetics about 33 years back. And Mr. Bahul Guna very, very, very beautifully said, I don't understand what M2M is. And let me tell you, that's the fact for about 99% of the industry today. We all talk about M2M. There's a whole lot of McKinsey's of the world, the Bergen sites of the world, all the big names that we talk about. All of them talk about 200 billion connected devices by the end of year 2020. Whatever, I mean, think of numbers. You can actually start learning your zeros from seeing those figures in those analytics reports, analysis reports out there. So, where is it? I mean, where are we going wrong? I mean, we've been talking about all these figures for the last 5 years. I've been into M2M probably for the last 5-6 years, and I've been seeing the same 50 billion, 100 billion, 150 billion, 200 billion connected device figures for the last 5 years. The only thing that changes there is 2005 as, to 2006 to 2007 to 2008, the latest figure is 2020 now. But it's still the same figures. We still talk about it, but we haven't reached where we say those figures are going to take us and the big business that we promise ourselves about. Right? M2M as a technology, I still call it as a technology, M2M as a technology has been there for years that we can think about. It was there in 1960s, 1950s probably, if I'm not having my ear wrong here, when the first satellite was launched. We probably called it with a very different name at that point of time. We've been talking about M2M with different names, cybernetics, telematics, telemetry, call anything. We've been having very different names, and believe me, we in the IT industry survive because of those jargons that pays our salary at the end of our month, because we have to have some new jargon every year if we have to keep our business and start coming onto these dais and talk about those jargons. I'll be very practical about that. So we find some new jargon every time. Yep. And M2M probably was the latest one, which I would say has been running for the last 5 years, 6 years. And sorry, you have the presentation. Thank you. Now, we have to probably start changing our thought process in terms of how we deliver or how we talk about M2M, machine to machine, as we go forward. Because M2M, as a technology, about devices being connected is probably there. People understand that, yeah, I have a fridge at my home, I have a refrigerator at my home, I have a washing machine at my home, I have this big equipment which is digging earth out there in the construction sites, a Tucson or a JCB, or big cranes that you see in the construction sites, all of those could be connected, and in a lot of cases, all of those are already connected probably. They're all connected through their SCADA systems. There's a whole lot of data, GBs of data, terabytes of data, petabytes of data, which are all being generated. It's being collected for a whole long number of years that you can think of. So when we talk to our customers, they say, we have petabytes of data. Now you come back and tell me, what can you do with that data? That's what I'm looking at. Is that what you listen to when you go to your customers? That's exactly what people are asking for. You can connect things. In a lot of cases, there are things which are already connected. What is that business benefit or the value that you generate out of all these billions of connected devices? And that's where the value and that's where the benefit of talking about M2M is going to come to all of us who are here and outside. Right? So what we believe today is we have to mature from just talking about machine to machine into what we call, or what we probably need to think of in a matured way, as service transformation. We've been talking about service transformation. Again, this is not something which is new. Service transformation has been, again, there for years together. But what we say is, how do we start talking about a connected service transformation, which is beyond just talking about M2M, or a bigger level, people replaceably use M2M and IoT in the same breath, which is again, which is probably has its own implications. But how is it that we essentially go beyond just talking about M2M? How is it just we go just beyond talking about Internet of Things and talk about the service transformation or the business transformation that we can bring about from these billions of connected devices? And that's where the value is going to be, and that's where we as a society, we as organizations, we as a business are going to get generate value and commercial benefit out of. I use a commercial benefit here. I, unfortunately or fortunately, I am part of a private organization, and I need to kind of start balancing between the commercial values and the social values that come out of any kind of a technology or the business benefit that we try to deliver out of that technology. Now, having said that, that brings me back to my, as I call this, necessary evil that I need to take care of in all the seminars and the presentation. I need to present my organization before I essentially go into talking about the crux of what I'm here for. So I come from Wipro. We are a multinational organization. You can see all the details of that. We are in multiple businesses. A lot of these businesses, the last one that you see there, Eco Energy, though I don't like to call that, Eco Energy is again a very typical business which has been set up for the energy sector in the M2M space. It was started off as M2M. We call that now as a connected service kind of a space. But that's a separate organization of Wipro which has been set up for delivering M2M in the energy space, and it's been doing business fantastically, I should say, for the last 3 to 4 years now. But that's just one part of it. But these are the different heads that we have. We all have about 150,000 odd people across the globe. We operate in 57 countries. Being in India, I think a lot of you would probably have had some kind of an encounter with us, be it in the consumer space in terms of your light bulbs, in terms of probably some of the consumer devices that we are into, or from an IT perspective if you come from a IT kind of side of things. So that's very briefly about Wipro. So this is just what I just talked about. We have to mature from just being what we call as M2M into what we need to call ourselves as creating a service transformation. Using the technology of M2M rather than just trying to create some business value, some kind of a flavor around just fleet management, or just connecting a patient to the back end, or just connecting a car across to the back end so that you can get the driving behavior. Yes, I have connected my car to the back end, I'm getting the driving behavior. I know when my driver is actually putting in a hard brake, I know when he is doing a hard acceleration. Excellent, I have that. I have the devices, it's available off the shelf, there, out there. You pay $10, $20 for a Chinese one, you get it. You pay $50, you get probably a professional, much more better one. What do I do with the data? What am I going to do with that driving behavior after that? And that's where service transformation comes into picture. Right? So this is how we kind of envisage how our service transformation journey needs to go. This is a very typical Wipro figure, but I think this is nothing wrong. I mean, there's nothing very different from what we would probably do as any other organization which wants to be successful in this space. So traditionally, past, we kind of divided that into past, present, and future. Past was all about reactive. So there are things happening there. You get to know about it. What is the kind of corrective action you take after you have got to know about what is happening out there? That's been the past. The next step, which is the next level of maturity, is around being proactive. You get all this data, but you start predicting as to what is going to happen. And this is across verticals. I mean, this is not specific to something that you have in the automotive space or the healthcare space or, for that matter, energy and utilities. It's across any of the verticals that you want to think about. It's a service transformation journey for any of these verticals. So the next step, the next level of maturity is around being proactive about it. I get this data. I'm still getting the equal amount of data that I was getting 5 years back, or probably more now with the technology and the kind of advancements that we are having. Now, what is it that I can proactively get to know from this data that I'm getting from all my assets, the billions of assets that the McKinsey's of the world are talking about, and proactively take actions in such a way that I can actually do a very improved service transformation or a next gen service transformation from the customers or from a society. So that's the next level of maturity. And we believe we are ready as a country and as a business today to go into the second level of maturity, where we are just not talking about connecting devices and saying, yeah, these devices are out there, but go into the next level of maturity where we can be proactive and start being, start creating a differentiated services for our customers and the society equally. The next level of maturity where we think it's going to take some time for us to reach, at least we're not there at that space, is the next-gen services, wherein you move on to the next level of maturity, wherein you start predicting in terms of your statistical data, and then you start controlling the behaviors in such a way that it behaves the way that you want. That's the next generation. So we started where it was reactive, then we matured ourselves into being proactive, and then we go into the next level where we start talking about making the things happen the way we want it to happen. So that's the next level of service transformation that we need to get into. But that's probably in the future. So that's the journey that we have to take in. Now, all of these variables, essentially, are always going to be based on three kind of informations that we always talk about when we talk about devices, assets being connected, right? So whenever we talk about devices being connected, we have information about the usage of those devices itself. I mean, if I say a television is being connected to the internet, so the actual usage of the television itself, what is the kind of insight that I can derive about that particular asset which is connected to the whole wide internet of things? That's product related data. That's one category of information which we have access to when we talk about multiple objects being connected. The second kind of information that we have access to is around the connectivity itself. M2M, again, as we say, M2M doesn't say that it all needs to be over wireless network or wireline network, or it has to be a long-range communication. There's no definition of M2M that says that. This box out here, talking to my laptop, probably using a short-range communication, which is Bluetooth or Zigbee or whatever it is, also is, by definition of M2M, still an M2M, right? So how is it that I can use this connectivity data, essentially, be it long-range communications, be it short-range communications, in terms of deriving more insight about what is this communication telling us, is the second kind of insight that we can derive out of this entire ecosystem. And the third kind of insight that we would derive is a service-related information. How is this? What is the kind of service models that we can define based on the information which is coming in or the services that we have to provide? Is that a particular type of device which is failing every 1 month or failing every 2 months? What are these underlying reasons which is making that particular kind of device fail every 3 months? So that's all very much related to the services across verticals again. So there are three types of data that we get. You can get different kinds of service insights. The last one, though, I say service, all of this is going to provide you some kind of information around how you can derive insight and you can improve your services that you deliver to the society and to your businesses, which in turn translates into service transformation. So that's where we have to mature into. That's where we have to get into. Excuse me. Now, having said that, I've tried to relate this to the kind of service transformation that we could do in our public services itself. Let's start somewhere. I mean, the predominant challenge that we have as a developing country, let's take India, and we've been having these discussions, I was talking to Mr. Gupta also earlier. The predominant challenge that we essentially have is around how is it that we can transform the public services that we have. I've just captured some thoughts out here. It's not exhaustive. Again, it's not that all of this is possible, but all of this is not done, right? There are a whole lot of things, when I touch upon them, there are a whole lot of things which are happening in pockets across India today also, right? So big challenges that we have is towards law enforcement, towards tax and revenue collection, consolidation, towards quality healthcare, towards next-gen municipality services, and the quality education. And in all of this, there is a service transformation possible, but it all needs to start from our own underlying maturity in thoughts, trying to understand that, yeah, there is a service out there, and we have to take the next step in terms of creating the transformation in the public services. And that's where the beginning is. And the beginning has happened at a lot of places, as Mr. Middle was also saying. There are quite a number of initiatives which are happening at a government level in terms of creating the framework, creating the structure in such a way that we can actually go into implementing some of these. For that matter, quality education using M2M as a technology again. Creating a service transformation in the education field is already being implemented in some small pockets in Orissa. In terms of quality healthcare, everything that I mentioned out there has been implemented as a service transformation model in certain pockets in Bihar. So there's a lot of things which are happening. In terms of the next-gen municipal services, wherein the garbage management is done, I mean, ensuring that the garbages are getting collected when they are supposed to be collected, they're being dumped at the places that they are supposed to be dumped in. How is this whole thing happening? Which contractor is essentially doing it diligently? Creating a service transformation for the society, for the citizens, in such a way that you actually bring up the services of the municipal corporation. This is being done in Hyderabad. There was a pilot which was done in Delhi. In Delhi, there was a pilot done around streetlight monitoring. Essentially, how is it that we can create a different model for streetlights in such a way that the streetlights are only up when there are people traversing or when there is a vehicle traversing on a particular street? Dim the lights when it is not in use, when the street is not in use. So in pockets, there are a whole lot of things which are happening from an angle of creating a differentiated services for the citizens in the public service space. So these are things which are happening. The only thing that needs to happen is for the public, the government, essentially to come together and create a model in which these kind of transformations can be taken across the geography of India, or for that matter, any developing country. So that's so I mean, I don't want to really go into that. This is, again, a sales pitch from a Wipro. So we kind of created the service transformation model. So we have this model wherein we bring the entire ecosystem, starting from envisioning what needs to be done, what are the challenges. Start off from the base. I mean, it cannot be just a solution. I have a fleet management solution, so I just don't go and sell a fleet management solution to Hyderabad municipality so that they can track their garbage truck. That is not going to help me. There is a business challenge beyond that. There is a service model beyond that. How is it that I can take the service levels from level 1 to level 2 by essentially creating the entire ecosystem for Hyderabad municipality? That is what should be my aim. That is what should be the thought process of us taking across services to our customers and to the society. So we've created a model in Wipro where we kind of diligently go through that process with all our customers, be it public sector, be it on the private side of things. And we've kind of found that it's very successful, and we are delivering based on that, both to our customers in the developing countries and in the developed countries. Of course, the models need to be tuned based on the ground reality and the ground challenges of each of these geographies, but it works. So it's all about how do we create a different, how do we kind of create a differentiated services for you. So that's essentially where it is. So I just would like to leave you with a parting thought. So it's all there. The technology is out there. The thought process is out there. It's all about the ecosystem. When I say ecosystem, it's just not a private kind of an ecosystem. It's all about the government, the consumers, the citizens, us, the companies like Wipro, who are essentially there creating the technology, etc. All of us coming together and creating a differentiated services which can take up our society by a level in terms of the kind of satisfaction. All the services that we provide to our customers and the society. Thank you.